The story says a lot about not only parenting and the way we relate to our children and how we, I think, at times over-supervise our children. It also says things about gender, you know, like, oh, the women, eventually the men kind of square off together like, ah, she's driving me crazy. Yeah, and she's driving me crazy. So maybe you and I can find comfort in a glass of scotch with each other. And the women do the same thing, like, ah, you know, he does that? Yeah, well, mine does this, you know, which is also a very common thing among couples. I think what's great about the story is that it approaches these intellectual ideas, and the characters are actually discussing these ideas, but that's not what's going on. It's funny, like oftentimes in life, there's what we're talking about, and then there's the way we're behaving. And there's a story of how we're behaving towards each other underneath the story of what we're actually saying to each other. And this is a classic example of that, I think, the script. We're talking about these high ideas and, you know, aspirations and, you know, our belief systems and our place in the world. And meanwhile, we're sort of acting like these children with, you know, the dynamics of our relationship become slowly unveiled. And I think that's the key to the success of Yasmina's play. Yeah, there's all these sort of little revealing moments about our belief systems that we are quick to judge the other people on, but it's much harder to admit our own frailties. But that's what satire does, you know. It's a perfect setup for comedy, I think, because whenever you put people in a situation that is difficult for them to deal with and make them behave in a way that keeps things polite, that's an age-old recipe for comedy.